Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 24/7. Main hu Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session we are going to discuss about the very important UN principles for persons with disabilities. We are going to discuss about the Poshan Maha because the month of September is going on, and also we are going to discuss about the Poshan Abhiyan, right, jo ki Prime Minister dwara launch kiya gaya tha. And also, we are going to discuss about the RoRo services of the Indian Railways. So, do watch the complete session and spread the knowledge. So, chaliye start karte hain with question number one, which is about the Poshan Maha. So, we have to consider these statements with respect to Poshan Abhiyan and identify which statements are incorrect. Okay. So, let us first discuss about the news. So, recently, guys, this month is September. So, this is the Poshan Maha, and jo Poshan Maha hai, wo 2018 se it has been observed as a month for nutrition. Okay, so this has been done under the Poshan Abhiyan. The month of September is observed as the Poshan Maha every year since 2018. And iske andar bahut sari activities organize ki jati hai that are focused on antenatal care, optimal breastfeeding, anemia, growth monitoring, girls education, healthy eating and etc. Ek quiz iske andar conduct karai gayi hai, and there is also one nutrition park jo ki Statue of Unity ke paas banaya gaya, जहाँ पे एजुकेशन और न्यूट्रिशन से रिलेटेड काफी चीजें, न्यूट्रिशन से रिलेटेड काफी एजुकेशनल चीजें चलाई गई थी. सो इट इज अ यूनिक काइंड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन पार्क दैट हैज बीन क्रिएटेड एट स्टैच्यू ऑफ यूनिटी, वेयर वन कैन विटनेस न्यूट्रिशन रिलेटेड एजुकेशन अलॉन्ग विद द फन एंड फ्रॉलिक. ओके, एंड दीज एक्टिविटीज आर फोकस्ड ऑन सोशल एंड बिहेवियरल चेंज कम्युनिकेशन. एंड वॉट इज दिस SBCC? सोशल एंड बिहेवियरल चेंज कम्युनिकेशन. सो इट इज द स्ट्रेटेजिक यूज ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन अप्रोचेस टू प्रमोट चेंजेस इन नॉलेज, एटीट्यूड, नॉर्म्स, बिलीफ एंड बिहेवियर्स. बेसिकली जो इसमें फोकस है सारी की सारी एक्टिविटीज में वो है SBCC के ऊपर, जिसका मतलब होता है जिसके अंतर्गत हमें अपने जो नॉलेज है, अपने एटीट्यूड, नॉर्म्स, बिलीफ और बिहेवियर्स को चेंज करना होता है. ओके, एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द पोषण अभियान गाइस, सो इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2018 ऑन द 8th of March, विच इज द इंटरनेशनल वुमेन्स डे, एंड इट हैज बीन लॉन्च फ्रॉम झुंझुनू इन राजस्थान एंड बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी. So it is also known as National Nutrition Mission. It is Government of India's flagship program to improve nutritional outcomes for children, pregnant women and lactating mothers. And Poshan ka ye full form hai, ye aapko yaad rakhna hai. Prime Minister's overarching scheme for holistic nutrition. So it was launched on 8 March from Jhunjhunu in Rajasthan. It is implemented by Ministry of Women and Child Development. Ye aapko yaad rakhna hai, because aap isko aise yaad rakh sakte hai because it was launched on 8th of March, which was the International Women's Day. So it is implemented by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. Okay, and इसके अंदर कुछ important targets हैं जो आपको पता होने चाहिए. Like we have to reduce stunting, underweight and low birth weight each by 2% per year. हर साल 2% हमें कम करना है stunting, underweight and low birth weight. And इसके अलावा anemia among young children, adolescents and women. इसको हमें कम करना है each by 3% per year until the year 2022. So we have to reduce stunting, underweight and low birth weight each by 2% per year by the year 2022, and we have to reduce anemia among young children, adolescents and women by 3% per year till the year 2022. And ye jo 2% ka target hai stunting ka, that is the minimum, lekin jo hame overall target achieve karna hai, that is from 38.4% in 2016 to 25% by the year 2022. So these are the targets under Poshan Abhiyan, and this is guys very very important scheme if we talk about the ESI section of the RBI grade B. Okay, and now let's move on to the question. The question is, the month of September is observed as Poshan Maha. Yes, since 2018 it is being observed as the month of nutrition. Poshan Abhiyan is implemented by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. Yes, and Ministry of Women and Child Development is headed by Smriti Zubir Irani. Her Lok Sabha constituency is Amethi in Uttar Pradesh. She defeated Rahul Gandhi in the 2019 Lok Sabha elections. And target of this Abhiyan is to reduce stunting, underweight and low birth weight each by 3%. No, it is not 3%, it is 2%. Jo anemia wala portion hai, that we have to reduce by 3% each year. So this is incorrect statement. So therefore the correct answer should be what? Option A, only 3. And now let's move on to the question number 2. And there are some information given about question number 2. And guys, question number 2 is all about the principles, UN principles for persons with disabilities. So the question number 2 is, which of the following is not a correct principle described in the first ever guidelines on access to social justice for people with disabilities released by the United Nations? And guys, this is very very important question. Ye aapke exam mein pakka aane wala hai. So, and question number three is also based on the persons with disabilities. So recently, United Nations, which is headquartered in New York, headed by Antonio Guterres, has released its first ever guidelines on access to social justice for people with disabilities. And there are total 10 principles jo ki launch kiye gaye hain. And these principles aim to make it easier for PWD, person with disabilities, to access justice systems around the world. And now let's talk about the principle. And guys, aapko principle yaad ho jate hain, toh well and good. बाकी देर इज वेरी लेस चांस कि डायरेक्ट प्रिंसिपल से क्वेश्चन आए, बट यस देर इज अ चांस कि क्वेश्चन आ सकता है. ओके, सो प्रिंसिपल नंबर वन इज पीडब्ल्यूडी शैल नॉट बी डिनाइड एक्सेस टू जस्टिस ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डिसेबिलिटी. उनको जस्टिस देना है हमें, उनको जस्टिस के लिए मना नहीं करना है. फैसिलिटीज एंड सर्विसेज मस्ट बी यूनिवर्सली एक्सेसिबल विदाउट डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. पीडब्ल्यूडी इंक्लूडिंग चिल्ड्रन विद डिसेबिलिटीज, दे हैव द राइट टू अप्रोप्रिएट प्रोसीजरल अकोमोडेशंस. They have the right to access to legal notices and information in a timely and accessible manner. They are entitled to all the substantive and procedural safeguards recognized in international law on an equal basis with others. Okay. And other than this, we have principle 6, and which says that PWDs have the right to free or affordable legal assistance. They have the right to participate in the administration of justice ऑन एन इक्वल बेसिस. आप ये याद रखेंगे, इक्वल बेसिस है यहाँ पे, कोई भी प्रेफरेंस इनको नहीं दी जाएगी. ऐसा नहीं होगा कि अगर कोई पर्सन है विद डिसेबिलिटीज देन ही विल बी गिवन प्रेफरेंस ओवर द अदर्स, ऐसा नहीं है. इक्वल बेसिस पे पार्टिसिपेशन दिया जाएगा इन द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द जस्टिस. ओके, दे हैव द राइट टू रिपोर्ट कंप्लेंट्स एंड इनिशिएट लीगल प्रोसीडिंग्स कंसर्न ह्यूमन राइट वायलेशंस एंड क्राइम्स. इफेक्टिव एंड रोबस्ट मॉनिटरिंग मैकेनिज्म्स विच विल प्ले अ क्रिटिकल रोल इन सपोर्टिंग एक्सेस टू द जस्टिस फॉर पीडब्ल्यूडीज. And all those working in the justice system must be provided with awareness raising and training programs ताकि PWDs के rights को address properly किया जा सके. Okay, so these are the 10 principles given by United Nations for the person with disabilities, and these are the very important because ये first time ऐसा कोई principle United Nations द्वारा दिया गया है. And if you talk about the PWDs population across the world, so according to United Nations there are around 15% of the world's population which are disabled, and they are the world's largest minority. And if we talk about India, our country, so according to the 2011 census, India ke andar jo person with disabilities hain, they are 26.8 million, which is a whooping 22.4% of the total population. So this is a very high ratio, guys. Okay, and in India, if you talk about, so Article 41 of the Constitution, Article 41 of the Constitution, DPSP, says provides protection to the person with disabilities. And other than this, we have Rights of Person with Disabilities Act 2016. Right? And under this act, we have a Chief Commissioner who looks into the matter related to the abolition of rights of person with disabilities. Okay. And International Day of Disabilities every year observed on December the 3rd. All right. And now let's move on to question number 2 and 3. So we have to find the incorrect principle. So PWDs have the right to participate in the administration of justice on a preferred basis. No guys, it is on an equal basis. So option A is the incorrect principle. So hamara yahi answer hona chahiye. Let's read out the other options also. PWDs have the right to free or affordable legal assistance. Yes, they shall not be denied access to justice on the basis of disability. Yes, this is also correct. PWDs have the right to appropriate procedural accommodation. Correct. And effective and robust monitoring mechanism will play a critical role in supporting access to justice for PWDs. So all other statements are absolutely correct. Option A is the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 3. One second. Yes. So question number 3 is, what is correct about the number of PWDs around the world and in India? So according to United Nations, around 15% of the world's population live with disabilities. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And according to 2011 census, number of PWDs in India is 26.8 million, which is approximately 22%. Okay. So both of the statements are correct. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option C, both are correct. And now let's move on to question number 4, which is about the first ever RORO service of Southwestern Railway from Nela Mangla to Bale has been started. So the question is, what is RORO? Ye RORO ka full form basically humse pucha gaya hai. Southwestern Railways, guys, it is headquartered in Hubballi. Hubballi is in Karnataka. Okay, and there are total 18 railway zones in India. The last one was the South Coast Railway. The 18th zone is the South Coast Railway, which is located in the Visakhapatnam. Okay, and now let's talk about this RORO service of Southwestern Railway. So first ever RORO service of Southwestern Railway has been started from Nela Mangla, which is near Bangalore, to Bale, which is near Solapur. Okay, and this will be the only privately operated Ro-Ro train services in the Indian Railways. जैसे पहले भी Ro-Ro services चल रही है, बट वो सारी गवर्नमेंट ऑपरेटेड है, इंडियन रेलवेज उसको ऑपरेट कर रहा है, बट दिस विल बी द फर्स्ट प्राइवेटली ऑपरेटेड Ro-Ro ट्रेन सर्विस. और सबसे पहली जो Ro-Ro ट्रेन सर्विस चली थी दैट वॉज इन द ईयर 1999 कोंकण रेलवेज में. ओके, जो हमारा कोंकण रेलवे जोन है वहां पे चला था. एंड बेसिकली ये होता क्या है, रोल ऑन रोल ऑफ. इसमें जो ट्रक्स होते हैं, इस तरीके से जो ट्रक्स होते हैं वो फ्लैट वैगन्स के ऊपर, जो कि ओपन वैगन्स होते हैं, उसके ऊपर लोड कर दिए जाते हैं. सो जो ट्रक्स वाले ट्रक हैं उनका जो रोड का जो जाम वगैरह है उससे उनको उससे बच पाते हैं, उनका जो फ्यूल है वो बचता है, जो रोड की जो कंजेशन है उससे बच पाते हैं. ओके, सो इट इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कैरिंग रोड व्हीकल्स लोडेड विद वेरियस कमोडिटीज ऑन ओपन फ्लैट रेलवे वैगन्स. ओके, एंड दीज आर द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ बेस्ट फीचर्स ऑफ रोड एंड रेल ट्रांसपोर्ट इन द सेंस दैट दे ऑफर डोर टू डोर सर्विस विद मिनिमल हैंडलिंग ट्रांसपोर्टेड बाय फ्लैट एंड डायरेक्ट रेलिंग. ओके, and first Ro-Ro services were first time introduced in Indian Railways in the Konkan Railways in the year 1999 aur tab se aaj tak chalte aa rahe hain. Okay, and question number 5 is also based on this. So now what are the advantages of Ro-Ro? So faster movement of goods and essential, reducing time taken by trucks, reduces congestion on the roads, save precious fuel, reduces carbon footprint, relief to crew of truck as it avoids long distance driving, no hassles of check post or toll gates, seamless interoperability between roadways and railways intermodal transport on existing track and ensuring uninterrupted supply of essential commodities. So these are basic advantages. आपको ये सब कुछ याद रखने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है, ये हम लोग एक basic idea भी इसका लगा सकते हैं. So the correct answer to question number 4 guys is what option A, roll on roll off service. And for question number 5, which of the following is not one of the advantages? So it increases carbon footprint. No guys, in fact it will decrease carbon footprint. So option A will be the correct answer. It is one of the disadvantage, it is not one of the advantage of the Ro-Ro train services. Okay, and guys if you talk about the Indian Railways, so recently Indian Railways ko $500 million ka loan mila hai from the AIIB for the Mumbai suburban railway system. Hum sabne padha tha ye Mumbai suburban railway system ke liye $500 million ka loan was provided by All India Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. Other than this, Indian Railways is making the world's tallest pyre bridge in the state of Manipur. All right, and India's first Kisan Rail, aap sabne padha hoga that India's first Kisan Rail ran from Devlali to Danapur, Devlali in Maharashtra to Danapur in Bihar near Patna. And other than this, India's first fruit train was started from Tadipatri railway station in Andhra Pradesh, Tadipatri railway station in Andhra Pradesh to Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust. All right, and iske alawa hum baat kare to railway board ke chairman hai VK Yadav is the chairperson of the railway board, and ministry of railway is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal. So these are some current affairs related to the Indian Railways. And iske alawa there is one Swavalamban Express that was launched by SIDBI. And this was launched to promote business aspirants. Okay, so these are some current affairs about the Indian Railways, and that's it for the session today. I hope you like it. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.